Boy, isn't this great? You're going to see the show. Don Adams and Don Rickles.
See. I can't wait to see that Rickles. He's funny. Now, he's funny.
No,
Adams,
you.
I don't care
no,
for
you
too
might.
Much.
No.
But Rickles
no,
is funny.
Adams,
when he
Adams
says,
rolls.
I hope you get a rash under your arm. That's funny.
There's no humor.
That
when
is
Adams
funny.
Comes out and says, all right, Inspector, ladies and gentlemen
that's
of the jury.
That's I don't
that's
care
great.
For that.
The lock
How
door?
About when Rickles
Claire.
Says, this is smart, sir. If you got a Ferris wheel, some cotton candy, and a horse that sweats
vicious,
a lot.
Vicious
that's
humor.
Funny.
There's no point to that. That is rotten humor. There is no humor there. Adams.
Baloney, Adams.
Where's he going? I tell you something right here and now.
Man.
That's why I don't like to
not
go out with you, because you don't know humor. You never knew
well,
humor.
Well, you'll come in
oh, yeah?
and you'll see
well,
how
I don't
funny
know
he is.
Yeah, well, look,
I'm sorry, gentlemen. No more seats.
No more seats.
Now you see? Now you see? We're going to miss the show.
Well,
huh?
It's not my fault, Waldo.
No.
Waldo?
Gee whiz, Renfro, we're going to miss everything.
Renfro?
That's right.
Well, it's your fault. You stood here arguing with me all the time.
And all you know is nag, nag, nag. I hope you go home and your baby brownie breaks.
Will you stop whining?
I'm not whining. I'm just fed up. Give me a break.
Tonight on the Kraft Music Hall. Don Adams and Don Rickles are alive and well and living in California. Starring Don Adams and Don Rickles. With their guests, Kay Ballard. The Beach Boys. And a special appearance by Joseph Cotton. Ladies and gentlemen, Don and Don.
Tonight we're going to do a show about California.
I'm sorry.
No, really.
It was my fault. You go ahead. Go ahead. Talk, please.
Tonight we're going to do a show about California. Look, I'm very fond of you and all that, but we just can't go on meeting like this.
No, I'm sorry, Don. Why don't you start off the show?
No, go ahead.
It's perfectly
all
right.
No, Don, it wouldn't be right. Really, I want you to MC, Don.
No,
really,
it's perfectly all right with me if you want to take over, Don.
No, you should. You should, really. It's only right. After all, you still have your own show on the air. And I'll just, you know, take whatever crumbs are left over.
Gee, Don, I'm sorry if you're that sensitive.
Oh, then I can't take over?
No, I'm just sorry that you're that sensitive.
It's fun doing a show with your best friend.
Tonight we're going to turn the spotlight on California, which will be the first time we've seen sunshine this year.
And I got canceled.
Tonight we're going to investigate and hopefully refute the charge that California is the nuttiest state in the country. The fact that California is shaped like a peanut is purely coincidental. Some of these ridiculous critics have gone so far as to make the ridiculous charge that one out of every two persons in this state is a nut.
Are you a California resident?
Yes, that's right, I am.
Do you mind if I ask you what kind of a home you live in?
Not at all. I live in a $150,000 home in Beverly Hills.
Oh, do you have a swimming pool?
Two swimming pools, one hot, one cold.
What about a car?
I have three cars, one for myself, one for my wife, and one for my gardener.
Do you mind if I ask you, what do you do for a living?
I'm a short order cook.
A short order cook? How much money can you make?
$68 a week.
$68 a week? How can you afford living the way you do?
Stick 'em up.
Yes, that's right. I'd like some perfume, hairspray, powder, yes, mud pack, facial cream, and a hairnet. You need anything else, Harry?
Hi there. Ralph Freebie here, your incredibly naive used car salesman. Once again, I'm happy to report that we are now running our one-time-only sale. That's right, today only and for the rest of the year. You can come in and buy any car on this lot for the exact amount of money we paid for it. Now, you can't do much better than that, can you? Now, I know what you're thinking. You're asking yourself, how in the world does Ralph do it? Well, you're in luck, because here comes a customer right now, and you can see for yourself.
Excuse me, sir. I was just watching you on television. I took a helicopter right over here. I'd like to buy this car right here, if I may.
All right, sir. That'll be $695, exactly what we paid for it.
Fine, sir. Here it is, right there.
All right. And here is your car.
Wait a minute. This isn't a car. This is cardboard. This is a phony. I don't want this. I want the real car. Give me my money back.
I'm sorry, sir, but if you want a refund, you'll have to speak to our sales manager.
Oh, that's better. That's better.
Colleges are places of learning and intellectual development and growth. And that's why I'm offering you kids $5 each to let me out of my office.
Hi there. Pardon me, sir. Are you a nudist?
Get out of here. What are you staring at? This isn't the park. Get out of here. What are you, a lonely guy? Get on the other side.
No, I'm a fig tree that went bad waiting for a bus. Stop staring.
Well, then, you are a nudist, aren't you?
Whoopee! No, I'm a rocket scientist.
Will you get around the other side?
But tell me, sir, how does one become a nudist?
You first got to work it out that the bush don't irritate you here. Well, it helps if you take your clothes off first. That's how you become a nudist.
I see, sir. Well, how long have you been a nudist?
Since my divorce, you dummy. In California, a wife gets everything, and she got everything. Will you stop staring? Don't I know you from someplace? Hope the cops don't come.
Son, a little something to eat. You've been working for six straight hours,
honey. Nothing now, Mom. Please, I don't want to eat anything now. I'm trying to write a song. Please, Ma. Not now. Later, later.
Nothing now.
I don't drink milk. I'm trying to create a song, Ma. Will you leave me alone? I don't drink milk when I am creating. Get out. Out, 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 out.
No milk when
out.
Creating. Eat now, create later, son.
Okay, that's it, Ma. I told you. I don't drink milk. I don't eat cookies. I don't want anything. Get out.
I got it.
M is for the million things she gave me.
Come on, Rocky! Come on, Rocky! Get it on, Rocky! Rocky, he's hitting you with his right. Keep your left up, your left. Get in there, Rocky! Come on, Rocky, baby! Come on, Rocky! Get in there! Wrong! That was wrong! Wrong, Rocky! He's hitting you with his left. Keep your right up. Get in there, Rocky! Come on, Rocky, baby! He's hitting you with both hands. Keep your hands up. Your hands up.
I'll kill him. I'll kill him.
Out of the way, Rocky.
Is that you, honey?
Yes, is that you, Shirley?
I'm not Shirley. I'm Bernice.
That's close enough.
While we try to work this out, may we present the original California sound of our guests, the Beach Boys.
I wish they all She's a gal who's such a big talent, it takes both of us to introduce her.
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Kay Ballard.
A place you love, my home upon the hill. I find I love you still. I've been away, but now I'm back to tell you. I tell.
Of apartment buildings for single people only. No married couples are allowed, just bachelors and bachelorettes. It's a great improvement on the age-old saying, it's better to have loved and lost than never to have moved in at all.
Hello, front desk? Listen, Marty, get me apartment 741, will you? No, not apartment 324. I don't go with her anymore. Yes, I know I used to go steady with apartment 324, but we broke up when she caught me out with apartment 438. Yeah, no, that was right after I broke my engagement to apartment 960. Listen, Morty, will you do me a favor? Just take care of the switchboard. Don't keep score. Hello, 741? Hi, 558 here. I was just checking on our date tonight. I thought we'd have a little din-din in my apartment, so I had some Japanese food sent in from Sukiyaki Delight. Yes. No, my roommate will be out for the entire evening so we can get a chance to know each other a lot better. Yes, well, just dress casually. Okay, see you in a jiffy, or whatever you're wearing.
Joe Raymond.
Raymond! What are you doing home?
I got the Hong Kong flu. That's what I'm doing home. I got the Hong Kong flu. I made a hole in my handkerchief.
Raymond, you don't understand. Raymond, you don't understand. You can't stay here. Now listen, Raymond. I'm having a girl. A girl is coming over here in a few minutes.
Well, I hope she's a nurse.
Listen, Raymond. Listen to me, sweetheart. You gotta do this for me. We're friends and you gotta do this for me. I want you to go and take a little walk. The fresh air is great for your cold. I want you to go and take a nice little walk. Why don't you go see your brother?
He lives in Minneapolis.
The trip will do you. I don't want to go on it. Sayonara!
You don't understand. Stay home, I got a bad coat.
Say, this is a smart outfit if you're a lady cop.
I gotta stay home, I don't feel good. Who you having for dinner, a midget?
Listen, Raymond, how can you be so inconsiderate? You knew that I wanted to be alone with this girl tonight. You deliberately went out and caught the flu.
What do you mean, I deliberately? I went to a street corner. I said, pardon me, sir, I feel great. Give me a case of the flu.
You're kidding me. Listen, I spent my last $18 on this Japanese dinner to impress this girl. Do you think I enjoy raw octopus and seaweed? Listen, Raymond, do me a favor. Look, do me a favor. Just go to the movies. All I need is a couple of bottles. So go to the movies.
Are you out of your mind?
A nice movie for a
Are you out of your mind in the condition I'm in? I can't go to no movie.
See Dr. Zhivago.
I wouldn't see Dr. Zhivago unless he was making a house call.
Maybe you'd be better off checking into a hospital.
They turned me down. I went to the hospital. They won't take me unless I have the flu.
Oh, I'm running a temperature. It's either that or I'm on Guam. Oh, I'm burning up. I must have 101, 110, 130. I'm dying.
Raymond, nobody could have a temperature of 130 and still be living.
I didn't say I was living. I said I had a temperature of 130.
Look, Raymond, if you're that warm, why don't you go down to the swimming pool and take a little dip and that'll cool you off?
I want to tell you something, Harvey. You're an inconsiderate person. I mean this from the bottom of my heart. You don't care about me. I could have the flu. I could drop dead on a street corner. And you'd have your sukiyaki dinner before you called the undertaker. You are no good, Harvey. You're no good. I want my mother.
Raymond. Raymond. She's here. She's here, Raymond. Now, before I let her in, I want you to tell me one thing. Are you going to have the flu for the entire evening?
With a little luck, maybe I'll get the bubonic plague.
Raymond, you're purposely doing this to me, and I know why. I know why. Because every girl in this building is crazy about me, and none of them like you. The only one who likes you is Morty, the telephone operator. And the only reason he likes you is because you never get any calls.
Oh, yeah!
All right, Raymond. All right. But you're not going to spoil my dinner. You're not going to spoil my dinner. I'm going to bring my girl in, and we're going to sit here, and you're going to watch us while we have our seaweed and raw octopus. All right. All right, Raymond. You refuse to go to the hospital. You refuse to go to the movies. And you refuse to swim in an unheated pool, which would have done your temperature a world of good. It is impossible to reason with a closed mind. This is my final word, Raymond. My final word. You are the most selfish, inconsiderate roommate I have ever had. And I would move out of this apartment in 1 minute if it weren't for the fact that you're paying 2/3 of the rent.
Hi, 741. Oh, what are you wearing?
Oh, well, I just got home from the office. I didn't have time to change.
Who's that?
It's my roommate. He's a hypochondriac. He thinks he has a cold.
Gee.
How do you do?
How do you do? I've never noticed you in the building. How long have you been living here?
14 years.
Don't look at him, dear. It might spoil your appetite.
Bless us.
I think I'm getting your flu.
Oh, no. Then get away. Don't come near me. I don't want it.
No, you're all right. You're all right. I'm telling you, you're all right. You look great. You look great. Please, give me a chance. Give me a break. I paid $18 for the drop in his food. Give me a chance to get even.
Well, Raymond, I hope you're satisfied. You have ruined my entire evening. Did you hear that?
What?
You gave me the Hong Kong blues!
So what? You're dressed for it!
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Joseph Cotten.
Thank you. A half a century ago, a small group of men came to California to find a place to make moving pictures. They settled in a small town called Hollywood. They were the pioneers of a medium that was destined to influence the thoughts and hearts and dreams of millions of Americans for generations to come. Hollywood, a world of glamour and make-believe, of great stars bigger than life, and of great movies that will live forever. And here are a few moments of nostalgia from that fabulous golden era. In the early 20s, millions of moviegoers were flocking to see a sad little man with a mustache, a derby hat, and a cane. Brought a new invention which revolutionized the film industry, sound. Here is Al Jolson testing for the part of the jazz singer, the first talkie.
I'd walk a million miles for one of your smiles, my.
A Keystone Comedy in the next studio, and one of the pies got loose.
All right, let's go again right away.
Shouldn't I take off some of this chocolate?
We don't have time to take the chocolate off. We're over budget now. Give me a break.
Roll!
I walk a million miles for one of your smiles, my.
Run it!
Al Jolson became a star, but the advent of sound meant the end of the careers of such great silent film heroes as John Gilbert.
Vera, my darling, you know how much I love you. Come away with me tonight.
I can't, Harry. I'm playing with the Green Bay Packers tomorrow.
In the early 30s, there was that lovable old scamp, Wallace Beery, who teamed with Jackie Cooper in one of the first great tearjerkers, The Champ.
Ah, gee whiz, kid, now, just when was it that you first realized that I was really your old man? Ah, gee, Champ, I don't know.
One man's search for the secret of peace and the meaning of life.
was brought to the screen by Ronald Coleman in an adaptation of James Hilton's great novel, Shangri-La, Lost Horizon.
No, High Lama, I have traveled halfway across the face of the globe, seeking and searching to find the meaning and the essence of life.
My son, life is a fountain.
That's it? You mean to tell me that I've traveled halfway across the face of the globe? That I've trekked the desert wastes? That I've climbed the Himalayas and all you have to say to me is life is a fountain?
Would you believe a bowl of cherries?
Then came the era of the tough guys. George Rapp, tossing a coin in Scarface. Edward G. Robinson in Little Caesar. And James Cagney in Angels with Dirty Faces.
Father Jerry, you know what he say, kid?
Rocky, in a few minutes you'll be going to the chair. And it's a favor I'm going to be asking of you.
Sure, Father, sure, anything for you.
I want you to turn yellow.
What's that? Yeah, see, I'm a life on the crawl of my belly. Get out of here, Jocko, spit right your eye, understand? Spit right your eye.
All right, Rocky, me boy. All right. But can I walk down the last mile with you?
Sure, Father, sure. But just do me one favor. Don't let me hear you pray. Understand? No pray.
You won't hear me. You won't hear me, Rocky.
All right, Father. Let's go.
The era of the tough guy also produced the dynamic Humphrey Bogart, affectionately known to his fans as Bogey. He made an impression that will last forever in such great films as Casablanca.
What's that you're playing, Sam?
Oh, just something of my own.
Well, stop it. You know what I want to hear.
I don't think I can remember that, boss.
Play it, Sam. If you could play it for her, you could play it for me. If she could stand it, so could I.
But, boss, I don't think you should.
I said play it, Sam.
But, boss.
Play it.
All right.
Bogart. Men respected his toughness, and women were moved by an innate tenderness in him. Who could ever forget the sizzling moment in To Have and Have Not with Lauren Bacall?
You know what's going to happen when Canino comes back? He's going to slap my teeth out and kick me in the stomach for mumbling.
I like that. You know, you don't have to play games with me, Steve. I'm hard to get. All you have to do is ask. You don't have to say anything. You don't have to do anything. Maybe just whistle. You know how to whistle, Steve. Just put your lips together and blow.
In the early 40s, it was the Swashbucklers, costume films of pirates and kings. Captain Blood, with Errol Flynn and Basil Rathbone.
Well, my friend Captain Blood, you have come to Cartagena once too often. And now, I shall teach you a lesson you shall not soon forget. I, Captain Levasseur, the finest swordsman in all of Cartagena. First, I shall cut your forehead. Then your eyes, your nose, your lips, your mouth, your ears, your neck. I shall rip the shirt from your body and the pants from your skinny little legs. Hey! Oh.
Oh.
glamour, the pomp, and the splendor of Princes and Kings was thrillingly captured in Anthony Hope's great classic, The Prisoner of Zender.
Well, Rupert, have you disposed of the king?
Yes, Black Michael. And now you shall sit on his throne. The king is dead.
Long live the king.
The king lives.
King lives?
One of the most beautiful of all the Hollywood glamour queens, Marlene Dietrich, made her debut in films over 30 years ago in The Blue Angel.
Falling in love again, never wanted to. What am I to do? Can't help it.
That was great. What other songs do you know, fella?
Great books were made into great movies, and the works of prominent authors like Emily Bronte, John Steinbeck, and Ernest Hemingway gave masterpieces to the screen, such as For Whom the Bell Tolls with Ingrid Bergman, Gary Cooper, and Akim Tamiroff.
The American. You come to provoke me, our American. Come and provoke me. I'm the leader of the guerrilla band. The men follow me, me, and me alone. They don't know you, American. You're nothing. And the woman, the woman. You want to be with the woman, don't you, American? I am the leader. You blow up the bridge, you'll do it alone, American. You and all them people that think they cannot take anything away from me.
Careful. Some of that's getting in your mouth. Maria, you're as pure as the driven snow. Of course, you've drifted quite a bit.
Through the years, Hollywood has given us many great character actors with those special mannerisms that give them an identity all their own. Among these was the wonderful Victor McLaughlin, seen now in a scene from Gunga Din.
Elephant knockout drops. There. Here's to Freddie Higginbottom, the finest blinking soldier since William the Bluebeard.
Sergeant McChesney.
Yes, sir.
Is that punch?
Well, not for you, Colonel. Yes, see, sir. Some people call it punch, but I call it swill.
Nevertheless, I'll have some.
Just a moment, sir. There's a fly in that punch. I'll get him for you, sir. Got him. Hear him buzzing around, sir. There he goes. Ain't that a shame?
Somewhere in a darkened movie house, it often happens that love emanates from the flickering screen and captures the hearts of an audience. It is then that a star is born. And such a star was Judy Garland.
I don't want to bother you, but I'll never forget the first time I ever saw you. You were getting out of a cab, and I was in the way, and you almost knocked me down. Oh, but it wasn't your fault. But then you looked at me, and you smiled. Yeah, you looked right at me and smiled. I don't care what happened. Let the whole world stop. As far as I'm concerned, you'll always be the top. You know you made me wrong. You.
As the movies grew into a multi-million-dollar industry, Hollywood was able to lure the great playwrights from Broadway. Heck, Kaufman, and Clifford Odets, who gave us the story of the sensitive violinist who wanted to be a prize fighter. Golden Boy.
Joe. Joey, why you want to fight? Why you want to hurt? That's no good, Joe. You want to play the violin.
Sure. Ever since I was a kid, all I ever did was play the violin. Well, Bob, I'm not gonna play it anymore. Here, take it.
Joey, you brought your fiddle. You brought it with you. Play, Joey. Play something pretty for Mama and me, Joey. Play.
That's beautiful.
Why you wanna fight? You play so beautiful. That's no good. You hit somebody, you ruin your gloves. Joe, my bambino. My little bambino, my Joe.
Pa, stop it. What are you talking like that for? We're not even Italian. Oh.
Some films are timeless. The passage of the years cannot dim their brilliance. They stand alone as a miracle of achievement. Such a film was David O. Selznick's Gone with the Wind. A monumental story of a nation's struggle to find itself. The search for Scarlett O'Hara took a long time, but Rhett Butler had been written in the image of the screen's greatest lover, Clark Gable.
I know you drink, Scarlett. I know how much you drink. Observe my hands, my dear. I could take your head and crush it like an eggshell if I thought that would drive stupid Ashley Wilkes out of your mind. But I know it won't.
Oh, Captain Butler, Miss Melanigan had a fine baby boy. I've done it mostly, Captain Butler, for Miss Scarlett. She helped some. Oh, Lordy, Lordy, Captain Butler, the Yankees is coming, and I'm scared of Yankees, Captain Butler. I'm scared of Yankees.
Tracy, you go upstairs and help Miss Melanie.
Yes'm. It's a long way.
Hurry, Prissy. Rick, where are you going?
I am leaving you, Scarlett.
But, Red, if you go, where will I go, and what will I do?
Frankly, my dear, I don't give a damn.
There's something that you love more than me, Scarlett, although you may not know it. Tara.
You mean to tell me, Katie Scarlett O'Hara, that Tara doesn't mean anything to you?
You get your strength from the land, Scarlett. Tara.
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 I won't think of it now.
And the great stars. Most of them are gone now. And in their passing, there is a sadness. For they came to be loved by the millions who identified with the magic of their personalities on celluloid. We've come a long way from the pie in the face to the development of the cinema as the sophisticated art form we know today. This is Joseph Cotton. Thank you. good night.
Most people think of California as a youth-oriented state, but the senior citizens also have their place in the sun. They may not swing, but they sure do rock.
I'm in here, you old dummy. I'm sorry about that, Lenny. I thought I'd finally got a chair with a cushion on it. Get me started, will you?
Okay.
One, two, three. Are you crazy, Lenny? You know how they hate it when you throw things on the floor. All right, now. Let's try it again. Here we go. One, two, three. Oh, there we are.
What a day. It's good to be alive, Freddy.
Speak for yourself, Lenny. I'm getting chair sick.
You know, Freddy, next week we'll be here 27 years.
You'll be here 27 years, Lenny. I've only been here 26.
How do you figure that?
I slept through 1961.
Yeah, I understand that. That's what happens if you don't leave a call with the desk. Can't complain now. Let's face it, still the best place in town for broads.
That's right, Lenny. Did you see the new shipload that came in today? Oh, nice shipload of young lovelies. 71, 72, just the way I like them.
Yeah, you always like those titty boppers, you son of a...
Well, you know me, Lenny. Love them, check their reflexes, and leave them.
Hold it. I think my heart stopped.
Yeah. How can you tell that?
I got a craving for pizza. Think you could kick it off and get me putting again?
Oh, sure, Lenny.
Here she goes. Humming and a bumping.
You know, sometimes, Lenny, I wish I had gotten married. This running around and staying awake until 6 or 7 at night is killing me. You know, I never could understand why you got divorced after being married for 74 years.
Didn't I tell you?
No.
I caught her cheating.
You're kidding.
That's right, yeah. I found out she was wearing support hose around her neck.
Oh, the old biddy. That's the way it is with women, Lenny. They're all alike, deceitful. Can I tell you about my date at the dance last night? Pull the old leg lock trick.
The old leg lock trick? What do you mean?
Right in the middle of the rumba, she locked her legs around the band leader and wouldn't let go. Dirty old lady.
Old biddy, old biddy. Rude old biddy. Precious old biddy.
At least you have children, Lenny.
What children? I got one boy, 65 years old, and he never comes to see me.
Well, maybe he's busy.
What busy? Lives in the next room.
Anybody around, Lenny?
Why, you see some ducks? Some ducks? Just a little... Zipper in there.
Here, Lenny. Chew on this for a while.
What is it?
It's meat. I found it in an old box.
You know, Daddy, I think you're ready for a state hospital. When you start finding meat in a book, you got a problem. I love meat. I forgot what it tastes like. Well, man, it's darn good, boy. I've been on Farina for 12 years.
Well, be careful how you chew it, Lenny. Remember what happened last week when I gave you those sour balls?
What happened?
Well, you sucked so hard you lost your memory.
Come to think of it, I don't remember.
Yes, sir. Well, let's start us up again.
Okay, here goes your burgers.
1, 2, 3. Okay, Lenny, that's it for you. No more meat. You'll get crazy when you eat meat.
I'm sorry.
I got a good mind to tell everybody you're sleeping the nude, y'all. You know, Lenny, we've been friends for a long time. And you've been very nice to me, Lenny.
You've been very nice to me, too, Freddy.
You know,
let me play patty cake.
You know something, Lenny. You know what? Something, Lenny.
What?
I forgot what I was trying to ask you, Lenny.
That's right.
Well, let me see now. Oh, yes. You know, you've been so nice to me, Lenny. I hope you live to be 100.
Big deal. That's tomorrow. Are you coming to my birthday party?
Yeah, well, I wouldn't miss it for the world. Are you going to have a cake?
Just a small cake with one candle on it.
Well, we better save up enough strength to blow it out.
Thanks, Freddy. I couldn't do it without you.
Well, good night, Lenny.
Good night, Freddy boy.
That's it for the Kraft Music Hall tonight. We'd like to thank them for giving us this opportunity to poke a little fun at this great state of California. We truly love living here in California. And if you notice, we didn't do any jokes about the Dodgers, the earthquakes, or the governor, in that order. Nor did we make any jokes about the mudslides, the water shortage, or the plague. And we never once touched on the real reason why Flipper and Lassie are never seen together. We'd love to thank our guests now, the very lovely Kay Ballard and the equally lovely Beach Boys. And a very, very special thanks to Mr. Joseph Cotton.
Don, I can't tell you how much fun it's been doing a show with you. You're a sweetheart, a great guy, and I love you.
Okay, let's have it.
Have what?
The insult that goes with that buildup.
I meant it sincerely. I love you.
Now, come on, Don. It's a known fact that you only insult people that you like.
I can't help it. I have nothing bad to say about you.
I've never been so insulted in my life.
Next week, two great stars host the Kraft Music Hall. Jimmy Durante and Don Knotts.
Maybe you could say something nasty about my wife.
I love your wife. And their guest list includes the beautiful Jane Powell.
Well, what about my kids? Maybe you could zing them a little bit.
I happen to love your kids as much as I love my own. Also on the show will be the sensational Baja Marimba Band.
Well, how about something nasty about my dog?
I love your dog. He's a pussycat.
Well, how about my maid? She's a good target.
Will you leave me alone and stop whining, you dummy? Stop it! You're making me bananas with your bugging and your bugging and your whining. Inspector, I can't take it anymore with that locked voice of yours. I'm fed up!
He loves me.
The Kraft Music Hall has been brought to you by Kraft. Kraft for good food and good food ideas. To get tonight's recipes free, write Kraft February TV Recipes, Box 1718, Chicago 60690. A postcard will do. This is Ed Herlihy.
Well, Jimmy, are you ready for our Kraft Music Hall?
Well, I've got my golden throat ready to wobble.
Yeah, I'm going to try to be funny, too.
Well, with Jane Powell,
Julius Wechter,
and the Baja Marimba Band.
Baja Marimba Band? Read it right, will you?
And me, Jimmy Durante. It's got to be great.
And me, too, Don Nuts.